Hi, welcome to this video. Today I'll be showing you how to host your own local bot API server. We usually do this to try and get around the 50 MB upload limit or the 20 MB download limit, which is actually really less for bots. Anyway, so if you want to upload larger files or download larger files, you can host your own server. You can do this by going to this open source code here, which Telegram have shown us here. They're really kind enough. And I'll show you how to install this on your machine so that you can also host your own server and get around these limits. Here you can see the advantages of having your own local API server. And now I'll actually show you how to do this. So if you click on here, the server build instructions generator, you have to first install this. So we can use this interactive page to try and install it. So here you have, operating system. I'm going to be using Linux because I'm using WSL. I'm using Ubuntu. So these are some options. You don't have to necessarily select them. I'm sticking with G++ because the file size is apparently less than Clang. So yeah, I'm just gonna stick with G++. So what I did is you just copy this into a file and you just run it. So depending upon your system, this can take up to like 10 minutes or something. And yeah, it depends on your network speed and your computer's performance, of course. So after this is done, I have it over here. If I show you, I have my Telegram bot API thing, which I've built on my own using this instructions. And if I actually go to that directory, you can see that all the files are here. And if you want to run the actual bot API server, what you need is, according to the instructions given, you need your API ID and API hash, which you get from going to this link, follow this link, see mytelegram.org. Over here, you enter your phone number and you'll get two things, API hash and API ID. So you want to copy those because you'll need them very soon. And make sure not to give this to anyone because it's very important. So you now need to officially run the server. But before running the server, you want to make sure that your bot has logged out from the actual Telegram servers. So you do this by using the logout method. And you must use this before running your own bot instance. So if I just run my bot here, just to call this logout method, you can see it printed true because it actually logged out from the servers, and that's why I got this error. So now I can comment that out again. And now I have to actually run my local bot API server. So to do this, after you've built your own thing and installed it for all the instructions, you can first change the directory to bin. Now you have, so now that we are in the directory, if you just run the API server, so you do that by just doing like a command. Now you need the API ID, which I have put as an environment variable for me. So I'll send it that. The API hash. Okay, and yeah, that's it. That's all we really need. So if I run this, okay, of course it's an error. Oh, there's no underscore. Okay, that makes sense. Let me just do this again. Okay, so as you can see, I got it running. Just have to change some capitalization and stuff. And now we have the server running. So because there's no output. So now what we can do is we have to go into our PTB. By the way, we need version 13.1 plus for this to work. So I'm currently on 13.7. And so now what we need is we need to just comment this line out. Yeah, and we have to put in our server address. So in my case, the server address, as you can see, this is the wiki page. In case you forget what to do, so make it, using the official server, you have to pass in this into your update or bot. So since I'm running locally, I don't really have a domain, so I'm just using HTTP 0000. And by default, it runs on port 8081. So when you do this and you run, you should be able to run your own port API server. And I'll just show you right now. Okay, so as you can see, I just started my file, ran the script. And now I have a command handler to check if I'm actually running through my local API server, which goes here. It prints my base URL along with the process ID and what I've just sent. So I'm gonna check. Go here. Let's check. Here we go. So now we know that the port is actually running through a local API server and not through Telegram's API server, which is great because now we can actually send large files to greater than 50 MB. Now you can see it goes here in this function because I've programmed it to here. Here we go. We have a larger than 50 MB file, which means our server works. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.